Classroom. My name is Marie. If you've not been here before, take a moment to subscribe because I have some amazing videos coming your way. Starting with right now, we are in my classroom setup or like update series. And today we're talking all about classroom decor. The last vlog that I put out last week was all about how I was planning decor because this room, actually my whole school, was having the carpets cleaned. So I couldn't get in. I have a special helper with me who wants to say hello. Here he is.
Hi guys.
He's the best. And so now I'm gonna actually start putting these things up on the wall. And as I'm in here and realizing, you know, when you actually like see it in the moment, you kind of realize, oh, there's some more things that I need to like supplement with. So I'm just gonna walk you around the room. Oh, and PS, I also completely forgot the posters that I made. So I'm gonna have to run home for those, but that's okay because I have some other things I need to make and print and then come back. It's gonna be a little bit of a process today. But I will show you the plans for the room and kind of reference the things I talked about in my last vlog, and then I'm gonna get to work.
We're going home while my mom finds the posters. I wanna, since there's like ants and stuff in here, I'm gonna suck them up with my bug sucker upper, and I'm also gonna get my own camera.
We have on our hands a budding vlogger. So he's going to get his bug sucker upper because we found a little ant attack because it's after summer and that's just what happens. So he's gonna get his bug vacuum and his little vlogging camera.
Cheap one?
Yeah, it's perfect for kids. Okay, this big huge wall is going to be the place where most of the posters that I made go. So I made those reading and writing skills posters, and they are going to go on here. All the reading skills posters on this side, all the writing skills posters on that side, and I'm gonna leave room around them to be able to put actually like active work and kind of takeaways from mini lessons that we do, because I'm gonna do a reading and writing workshop. And then if I go around the room, up there, as you saw in my storage vlog, is going to be like student materials and student supplies. Here is a silly little almost first grader.
I'm six.
And I'm gonna keep the front board as blank as I can just cause I like that. Stay tuned for an updated cell phone policy. It's been all the rage on my channel lately. Kids have been coming on and slamming me about my cell phone policy from March. It's just really funny. Over here, I've got my whole teacher area. I showed you that in a vlog. And then up over here on this board is going to be some more of the interactive decor elements. So over here, I think I'm just gonna leave this part open because this is my little makeshift standing desk for things that I need to kind of take care of. This half of this whiteboard is gonna be treated just like a bulletin board, and it's gonna have refrigerator worthy across the top, which I had last year, but I'm gonna cut new letters because it needs a little revamp. And that's where I can showcase student work, but I'm gonna leave it pretty open so it can just kind of be put up there. And I have a whole ton of little, like those little tiny magnets that I'm gonna put on some more clothespins so I can just easily put student work up. And then this side is going to be that currently board, currently reading, watching, and listening to, that students are going to be able to, we're gonna update it monthly, and they're gonna fill out little cards, and we're just gonna like swap it out monthly. So that's gonna say currently. There's gonna be a big printout down at the bottom over here of like a computer, because really kids don't watch TV, they watch it on their computers. And a book and some headphones, because literacy is not just reading, it's watching, it's listening, it's all of those things. That's gonna go up over here. Over here is going to be my classroom library. So I'm not really gonna work on this just yet today because that is a project in and of itself. Oh, and there's one more thing that I forgot that I wanted to show you guys, but I will show you when it's all up. I made a couple of different things. I made a poster that is gonna go somewhere up here, maybe it'll actually go over here by the light switch, that is about coffee shop mode, right? And like how, and how we are expected to be interacting and behaving during coffee shop mode when we're doing independent work. And the other thing I made is little agenda labels, daily agenda labels. I'm basically taking a note from my elementary and middle school colleagues that have all those great agenda labels, like first we do this and then recess and blah, blah. Obviously like high school, I'm not gonna have recess. I have 90 minute block periods. And so I'm just gonna chunk up the way my class periods go with different activities that are like more on like a rotating basis. I'm rambling because I'm realizing that explaining this without showing it to you isn't going to make a whole lot of sense, but that's something that you will see in just a few minutes. But for now, my mom and I are going to be putting borders up. You can see the black border going up. Last year I had those book pages, which were cool and very like, wow, look at that. But as the year went on, it started to like cave in around us, and it was just a little bit too much. So I think just nice black trim and borders is going to be fantastic. And then I have to go home because I'm a dingle hopper and I forgot the things I need. Here we go. I'm really excited because I have things to show you. Mind you, these projects are not completely done. In fact, what you saw before was yesterday. Today, my mom and I especially, and I've had a couple graduates from a few years ago come back and help me, and it's been so wonderful having them here. And my kids, obviously, my children have been helping a lot because you know how a 3 and 6-year-old are really good at putting out bulletin boards. But we've got some things in the works, and I'm excited to kind of like show you, especially how these things are going to be like working throughout the whole entire year and kind of building and being really functional. And then also I have some interactive spaces on the board where my students are going to be doing things. So I'm just going to kind of run you around the room, and it's a mess in certain places just because things are still happening and still in the works, but I'm really happy with the way that things are coming along, and I wanted to show you the progress and just the things that I've created to try and really streamline productivity in this room. Because while I do have my students every single day for 90 minutes a period, like 90 minutes every single day, it still feels like there isn't enough time to get everything done. And I want like transitions is a thing that I'm gonna be working on a lot this year, is just making them a lot like cleaner and more efficient, and having a bell ringer every single time that students walk into this room for class to start. They need to have something to do and have purpose that sets the tone for the day. So like I'm trying to create decor items and things like visuals for the room that are functional and pretty. So let me show you, I'm just gonna go all the way around and show you what we've been doing. So we can start, oh look, it's me in the mirror. We can start over here. This is like right inside of the door, obviously, there's the door. It was a lot busier last year. I had a lot more going on, and I'm liking it just kind of clean and sparse. You'll notice that this is a theme. Things are becoming much more clean and sparse and like open and airy instead of like over-decorated, which I think was a thing that I had going on last year because I was just so excited. But just a little welcome, maybe a quote of the week, a little like last look before we go, some different sorts of things that are going on over here. And then this board, the one with all of the reading and writing skills, when I had them up yesterday and they were kind of all over the place, I don't know, it just looked a little too jumbled. So I took all of the reading and writing skills posters and I put them up at the top. I know it's hard to see because of the glare. So I got these sentence strips at Target, and they're the ones that have the dry erase, and I cut them a little bit shorter because they're longer than, they're like probably 3 inches longer than this. And what I'm gonna do right now, they're just stuck up with double-sided tape, but basically, so whenever I do like a reading workshop mini lesson, and let's say I'm talking about author's choices, maybe the choices that we were talking about is in building character. And so I'm gonna write some sort of a like takeaway from that mini lesson about characterization, one about figurative language, blah, blah, blah. Like whatever the mini lessons are that I do revolving around identifying and analyzing author's choice, bam. Author's craft, bam. And so if you missed my vlog about creating these posters that I did last week, I will link it down below. But just so you can see, like, my plan for working these is that I can put the takeaways from mini lessons that I do down below and always have somewhere to reference back to. I think it's going to be nice. Same thing with like writing skills. So if we're looking at like questioning and inquiry, and I do like a thing on research, I can have a little bumper sticker slogan like takeaway, and then every time I do an inquiry and research, I have something to like go back to and reference, and hopefully that like recall of prior knowledge, transfer of knowledge will start to happen and things will start to come together if we put our actual lessons up on the board. I don't know, we'll see. Over here, I revamped the lenses in literature posters. I like made those a little bit more cohesive. They used to be on a wall back over here last year, but I like it up over here. It's one of the first things you see when you walk into the room, and I have those big, huge wood glasses that my mom had gotten me for my home office, and I was like, oh my gosh, they'll be perfect here. So if you want to get these, I'll link down below. These are from Dot Cop Teaching. Jenna Copper made these, and she actually added a couple more, so I have more up there now. If you have these already, you need to make sure you download the update because she put a couple more on there. Over here on the other side of the board, I'm gonna close up so you can see a little bit better. I made these like schedule labels. They just have magnets on the back. Well, I have 10th grade classes and I have 12th grade classes. And so I created for myself all these different cards. So like if we're gonna be doing independent work, coffee shop mode, on Fridays, I'm gonna be doing first page Fridays instead of first chapter Fridays to like save time. If we're gonna be doing a reading workshop, I can like put this up and put whatever the skill is from over here. This is gonna be the skill we focus on today. And like I can put it up within the daily agenda and they can just kind of see what's coming without, I don't know, just without a whole lot of extra work on my like plate. So those are just down there. I'm really happy with the way that those turned out and I think it's gonna be nice. And then the last two things that we worked on with decor over here is refrigerator worthy work. So it just says refrigerator worthy. I'm gonna try and find some sort of a clip art that I can blow up like I did these of a refrigerator or something like that. And I can use magnets to put up student work that I'm gonna showcase. And then over here is that currently board. I also showed this in my vlog when I was talking about planning all this decor when I couldn't get in here last week. So check that out. If you want to see, it's these little squares of paper where students are going to be writing like what they're reading or listening to or watching, and we can kind of just always have that kind of stuff up there. Over here is a vlog for another day, and that's going to be my classroom library, so I'm excited about that. So yeah, there you have it. Like I said, it's still a work in progress, but I'm really happy with this progress. I'm really happy, really happy with my hair. I'm really happy with how much more interactive the space is gonna be and how much more functional and usable it's gonna be, not just as like a teaching tool, but also for my students to be like, become part of the community of the room and like really leave their mark in a positive way. Like by leaving their current like watching and reading and listening recommendations and that sort of thing. So yes, I will keep you guys updated as I keep doing more work. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. If you start to get inspired by something and you wanna share your inspiration, please do so, because we can always use ideas from each other and like spread the positivity and share the wealth, right? Work smarter, not harder. All of the little cliche things about collaborating. And with that, I bid you adieu. Thank you so much for watching. If you have not already subscribed, please take a moment to do so. Hit the little bell so you don't miss any of the alerts for the future videos that are coming out about this like classroom setup series and all of the other things. And make sure that you follow me on Instagram, because I'm doing a lot more stories. And as school starts, I will be doing a lot more daily like classroom happenings and what I'm teaching in my Instagram stories than on vlogs. And vlogs will just kind of like show some things here and there, but every day I'll be on my Instagram stories. So I will see you guys next time. Have a good one. Bye.